Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. I appreciate it that all of you have come back to continue watching these videos. If this is your first video that you've seen, I don't know what to tell you. I've been doing this for a while, every day, or Monday through Friday. But anyways, you came to a great video, thank you, and if you haven't subscribed yet, please do subscribe. Like and share this video, comment below. I do read every comments that I get, okay? So today, as you may have read in the title, is general Halloween trivia questions, okay? And I thought I'll go ahead and do the questions and answer them type of thing for you guys, so you don't have to like look it up or anything like that. So there are, let me see how many, 25, 29. So I hope to see you guys at the end of this video also. So anyways, first one is, what is the name of the Celtic Harvest Festival that many people believe Halloween is based on? There is some debate as how many Samhain traditions made their way into Christian holiday of Halloween. This is because the Celtic people had an oral rather than written tradition, and so much about the life of Druids and the traditions of Celtic people has been lost. Halloween is the eve of All Saints Day, and we all know that All Saints Day was moved from May 13th to coincide with Samhain, which was held around October 31st to November 1st. By moving the Christian holiday to the date of a pagan festival, converted pagans could keep celebrating their traditional holidays while still being Christians. So it wouldn't be surprising if newly converted pagans incorporated the old traditions into the Christian holiday. What is a hollow? Hollow, this is like saint or holy person. Hollow, when used as an adjective, means holy, and as a noun, it means someone who is holy. You can see All Saints Eve, is also known as All Hallows Eve. In what year will be the next full moon occurring during Halloween? And that would be 2020. The last Halloween that had a full moon was in 2001. And next full moon will be Halloween after 2020. Won't occur until 2039. The more you know. I do hope you guys do like this trivia questions and trivia information and everything. And if I happen to say something off of this list that you guys know, please do leave them in the comments below. What item is banned only during Halloween from 12 a.m. October 31st to 12 p.m. November 1st in Hollywood, California? And a silly string. If you know more about specifically why it's a silly string, please leave it in the comment below. I may actually pin it, that comment of yours. What popular fall festival activity did the Romans bring to Britain when they invaded? Bobbing for apples, or some of you guys might call it apple dunking, duck apple, duking. Another variation was also played where apples were hung from strings and contestants would have to try and bite into them. I've seen both ways. I've seen it at different types of like get-togethers. Like if it's not on like a Halloween thing, it's hung from a tree, string and everything. But if it's like during a Halloween type of party or on Halloween itself, it's in like some sort of container or thing to get a bunch of apples in. Okay, next one is, the word Halloween is a concentration of what Christian holiday? And that's All Hallows Eve. Okay, All Saints Eve, All Halloween type of thing. and Scott's Eve is even, and the V was eventually dropped, as well as all and the word S, the letter S in Hallows. So All Hallows Eve became Halloween. Halloween is the day before All Hallows Day, also known as All Saints Day, and the first day of All Hallowtide, which is a 3-day celebration for Christian saints. I don't know. Okay, just to let you know, I haven't read all these before making this video. Okay? But yeah, when it came, with this last one, number 6, it also makes me think of the Mexican tradition of the November 5th, I believe it was, or it is, them doing the Day of the Dead. In correct spelling of the Halloween, where is apostrophes placed? It is between the two E's. The apostrophe shows where the V was dropped from All Hallows, even, Halloween, even in Scots mean evening. So this might be a trick-or-treat trivia now. In what two countries was guessing the tradition of dressing up in costumes and going door for food or coin for Halloween most popular? It's Scotland and Ireland. Okay, guessing during Hallowmas, the Christian holiday that Halloween kicks off has been going at least since the 16th century in Scotland. Guessing along with Soling are thought by many to be the origins of modern day trick-or-treating. When people go house to house while Soling, what do they ask for? This sounds like a joke to me, but it's probably because I'm American. And it's soul cakes. Soling goes back to at least to the 15th century and involves people going from house to house singing for soul cakes during Halloween. Soul cakes are small round cakes that are baked to commemorate the dead. Even though Soling did involve dressing up in costumes, like guessing, you can see why many people think it had a strong influence on the trick-or-treating that we do today. In what country was the first written account of children using the phrase trick-or-treat on Halloween? Canada. My favorite neighbors to the north. Here, you find a line from the newspaper. The youth tormentors were at back door and front demanding an edible plunder by the word trick or treat, to which the inmates gladly respond and sent the robbers away rejoicing. Trick or treat is demand. From a Herald, Lethbridge, Alberta, November 4th, 1927, page 5, Dateline, Blackie, Alberta, November 3rd. In what decade did trick-or-treating as we know it today start gaining popularity in America? The 1930s. If you know anyone that was alive as a child in the 1930s, ask them about it. And leave me a comment below, okay? Or if you want to make a video response, just tweet me the video response at ChucklesPig, and I'll watch it, definitely. Let's see, at 12, how many children have been seriously injured or killed from poison candy given to them by strangers during Halloween? You'll be surprised. 0. There have been a few cases of family members tampering with candy and blaming it on strangers. There have also been numerous false alarms where an illness was thought to be caused from Halloween candy, but later was discovered to be something else entirely. There are also there have been a teeny number of instances of sharp objects put into the candy by strangers, but luckily no one has ever been seriously hurt by one of those objects. I remember seeing years ago, or at least so every so often, right after Halloween of, or even before Halloween, people buying candy and everything. And there's one instance I remember, an individual grabbed all the, this one particular candy, placed it in something else in the store, and then I don't know if it, they one by one with the whole instance taking one piece of candy, bringing it home, putting something in it, like resealing it, putting it into the candy thing, and kept doing it and everything, and there were complaints about that. Okay, let's move on. Jack-o'-lanterns and pumpkin trivia. What were the original jack-o'-lanterns made from? Turnips. Also mangled warts. W-U-R-Z-E-Ls. Impossible rutabagas. Got so much hair on my mic. That isn't funny. It's distracting. Okay. So, jack-o'-lanterns refers to a light that is sometimes seen in bogs or marshes. It was explained in Irish folklore as being a stingy Jack who avoided hell by tricking the devil, but was denied entry into heaven due to his sins. He now has to wander the earth and light his way with an ember from hell held within a turnip or rutabaga. But am I pronouncing that correctly? Rutabaga. Okay, anyways. In what country did carving jack-o'-lanterns originate? Ireland. Just like today, faces were carved into the turnips and a candle was placed inside. They were used to frighten people and to drive away evil spirits. Let me know in the comments below if you have, carved pumpkins and more than just the traditional, the eyes and the weird mouths. Like, did you do, like, get one of those, a booklet with the different things, designs on it? Like, did you put a Disney character on it, a goofy face, a witch flying a broom? Type of thing, I would like to know if you have never done it, carving things like that, okay? And if you have, how soon after getting the pumpkin did you actually carve it and everything? The round orange pumpkins that are used for most jack-o'-lanterns today are native to what country? Continent. What continent are they? And it's North America. The oldest pumpkin-related seeds were found in Mexico and were dated to sometime between 7,000 and 5,500 BC. Thank you, Mexico. What country holds the title for the world's heaviest pumpkin? World's heaviest. Okay. And it's Switzerland. In 2014, Benny Mirror, sorry if I mispronounced it, your name, of Switzerland grew a pumpkin that weighed a whopping 2,370 pounds. That record is still stands in the, at the time of this article, which was September 2016. So last year. Sorry. Halloween by the numbers. Okay. Sources for these statistics from National Retail Federation and the National Confectioners Association. Number 17. How much are American consumers expected to spend on Halloween? How much money was expected on Halloween for last year? Plus or minus $5 million. Okay. Before I have the answer, I remember hearing that Halloween, I believe, or was it Christmas? It was one of those two holidays. I think it was Halloween. But it's more candy. more candy is spent during Halloween than Valentine's Day or something like that. Or for Chris, I could be doing this for the Christmas one also later on next month. Watch out for the Christmas special I have. I have it, I think Christmas, people spend more money. I think it's either more on candy or more on presents during Christmas or Halloween than it is on Valentine's Day. But anyways, so how much are American consumers expected to spend or had for Halloween last year? And it was $8.4 billion. Wow. Halloween is the second only to Christmas for holiday consumer spending. Oh, there's the answer right there. Halloween is second only to... So there's Christmas spending, and then there's Halloween spending right underneath. So, voila, more spending. Okay. What candy is the second most popular Halloween candy? Second. Not what you think it could be, but was it overall. And it's candy corn. So if your second favorite, what you think is second favorite, might not have been candy corn. Okay, if your answer was not candy corn, let me know what you think it was. I actually saw it to where somebody made a picture with candy corn and everything, and or with the yellow inside or the white inside and everything, and it made a corn and everything, and it was pretty cool. Okay, chocolate dominates first place by a wide margin, and everything compared to, so there's chocolate, then candy corn. Of course, so many of the candies have chocolate. There's Milky Way, pretty much anything with Skittles. Well, not Skittles. Snickers, that's what it is. That has chocolate. A lot of the products have nuts in them. I've actually heard of some people who have, like, they're asked the trick-or-treaters, are you allergic to nuts? Or anyone that group kids, and they have it separated to where candy with nuts and candy without nuts. Have you guys ever done that or known anyone that has done that? A lot of people actually give out apples and everything. Okay, let me find my place. Okay, what percent of American parents say they don't eat some of the children's candy? Plus or minus 5%. And looking at the number, that's kind of high, but it's still significantly low. And it's 22%. Seems a little too large of a percentage, but then I guess some of the survey takers might not have been totally honest. I met one parent, or two parents, that don't eat their kids' candy. Number 20. In the USA, how many pieces of candy are most commonly handed out to trick-or-treaters? How many pieces? And it's two pieces. Two pieces were most common at 50%. Next up being three pieces at 22%. If you've ever given out candy to someone, how many do you give out? Do you give out two? Do you give out three? Or are you one of those people to where you just give out one, like the king size candy bars and everything? Or are you one of those people to where you put candy out in a bowl and you put up a sign that says, please take one? There's so many kids that don't like you think, oh, they're not here, sitting here, let's just take a couple. Okay. 21. In terms of parties held in the USA, Halloween is third. What 2 days have more parties than Halloween? Of course, that's an American thing. I'm looking at the answers. New Year's Eve is one. And if you... It's one of those things that I believe that if you're not American, you won't think of this. You probably have some other sport that's probably big in yours, but the other, the second biggest, or one of the other two biggest parties than Halloween is the Super Bowl. American football, biggest one. And it doesn't surprise me at that. I've been to a few big Super Bowl parties. Well, small. I've held a few parties at my place over the years, at my parents' place and everything. Small get-togethers and everything. What percentage of Americans plan to celebrate for Halloween? Plus or minus 5%. 69% had planned on celebrating Halloween last year. That's pretty cool. Do you guys plan on celebrating Halloween some way or another? Even if it's like a day before or after? Let me know in the comments below. Okay. Halloween costume trivia. What was the most popular Halloween costume for adults in 2015? And let me know in the comments below what you guys found out about the popular costumes of 2016. And the popular adult costume for 2015 was a witch. Next up was an animal of some sort, followed by characters from Batman. Fourth place was a zombie, and the fifth place were characters from the Star Wars universe. Okay, what was the most popular Halloween costume for pets in 2015? And it was a pumpkin. I got him a costume. My dog can't see, but he's right next to me. I got him this little outfit you put around his legs, and it's a striped prison outfit, and it says "Bad Dog" on it. Okay, what next was up? Next up was a hot dog, undoubtedly top pick for Danish owner, Dash Hound owners. Third was characters from Batman franchise, followed by Devil. And fifth place was Bumblebees. That would have been so cute on dogs. If you happen to have a cat, have you ever dressed up your cat in some sort of outfit? And if you have, let me know. Because I actually do want to see those pictures of cats dressed up. 25. In what American state is it illegal to dress up like a priest or a nun? Which state? And it's Alabama. One of the South states, man. Here's the wording of the law in section 13A-14-4. Fraudulently pretending to be a clergyman. Whoever, being in a public place, fraudulently pretends by grab or outward away to be a minister of any religion, or nun, priest, rabbi, or other member of the clergy, is guilty of a misdemeanor, and upon conviction shall be punished by a fine not exceeding $500 or confinement in the county jail for not more than 1 year, or by both such fine and imprisonments. It's Acts of 1965, first exercis number 273 P381, code 1975, and it's A with this weird symbol, 13-4-99. So yeah, it's one of the states here in America is like, don't dress like it, you'll get up to a $500 fine, or up to a year in prison if you dress like that. And if you do dress up like it for Halloween, use caution. Do it, like, not in public. You know, private parties or something. Don't even do it then. Where did Mary Shelley get her idea for Frankenstein's monster? Ooh, I like Frankenstein's monster. What do you think? And it's from a dream. The inspiration for the book was from a dream, but the reason for writing a story was a competition suggested by Lord Byron to a group of friends and associates. They were competing to see who could write the best ghost story. Frankenstein's monster was supposed to be a ghost story? Okay. As a side note, the first vampire story written in English titled The Vampire was also written for the competition by Lord Byron's physician. I give up. I feel like throwing this paper, but I still don't read it. Seriously. Oh my gosh, the way these stories were made. You know. Competition, okay, fine. But. Oh my god, so weird. Anyways. 27. In the Middle Ages, why were so many mummies bought and sold? And it was to be grounded into medicine. I heard this a few years ago. Mummies were grounded up during the Middle Ages to make medicine because they were thought to have healing properties. After the Middle Ages, the buying and selling of mummies remained popular. During the 17th and 18th century, mummies were used to make a type of paint called mummy brown, or mumia. During the 19th century, mummies were bought for parties during which a mummy would be unwrapped and examined by the guests. Okay, I've heard about the painting and the healing things, but I never heard about unwrapping the mummy parties. Yeah. 28. What was Bram Stoker's original name for Dracula? Count Vampire. He changed the name from Vampire to Dracula after he borrowed the book An Account of the Principles of Wallachia and Moldavia from the library in Whitby in 1890 during his summer vacation. And this is a source, A Dracula Handbook by Elizabeth Miller. Let me know if you guys actually read the book of the long title I just read. An Account of the Principalities of Wallachia and Moldavia. 29, last one. And I hope you guys have actually been enjoying this the whole video, even though it's like half an hour long. 29. What was the first feature-length werewolf movie? And it was Werewolf of London, released by Universal Pictures in 1935. There was an earlier silent-era film titled The Werewolf, released in 1913 by Universal Films, but its runtime was only 18 minutes, far from the feature length, and no copies remain. You could probably count that one if someone got it, but it's definitely a deep cut. Just thought I'll mention it in case you or someone you're quizzing is a serious film buff. There you go. I hope you guys enjoyed this. I'm looking forward to all your guys' answers to the questions I have asked during this video. Please do comment. Please give this video a like, especially because it's Halloween. And if you haven't yet, please do subscribe. Okay. I have many more videos coming out. Please look at all the videos I have put out. I hope you guys have enjoyed these videos, and including this one. And I just to let you know, if this is the first time seeing my video, I have been doing this since July 17th, 2017. So, not too long, okay? So, until next time, peace, everyone.